50 years of racing the funny car, that's what we're celebrating in 2016. And right now, the countdown of Tony Pedregon's top 20 rolls on with his number 11 pick. Take it away, Tony.
This was close to home. TV Tommy Ivo Rod Shop Dodge.
There
now, this
go.
Was the 76-77 Dodge, Tommy Ivo's first funny car after a career with the famous four-engine car in a series of top-fuel dragsters. Originally a Plymouth Duster, but when Tommy got sponsorship from Dodge, off came the front end and on with the Dodge clip. Reincarnated by myself, yours truly. Why? Because TV Tommy Ivo was a big name in our sport. Now, this car can be seen. It's got a new home at the Dream Car Museum in Evansville, Indiana, and it will be on display at the biggest race of the year, the Indy Nationals.
And you got to love and appreciate a guy that went from the Mickey Mouse Club into the seat of a funny car. Pretty good stuff. Now to the fans' number 11 pick. What do they say?
Well, 1972-73 rear engine, Dunn and Reeves.
You know what's going to come up
funny
sometime.
Car, yes. Engine behind the driver. Big Jim Dunn says the idea was to build a safer car that took the driver out of harm's way and away from the engine fire. Also said during the burnout, no smoke in the driver cockpit because there was a fire shield separating the driver from the engine. Eight of these rear engine these cars were built. Seven of them went over backwards. With the motor in the rear, it did allow for a better launch, but it made the front end very light, unstable to drive. And this funny car was featured, you got to watch this movie, Funny Car Summer, from the early 70s.
And it was in that very car in 1972 at the Ontario Super Nationals. Jim Dunn won in the Dunn and Reith car. Who did he beat?
Well, he beat the very Barry Setzer car that came in number 13 on the fan vote.
That's Pat Foster that's driving. Let's compare and contrast side by side. And Tony, when you see numbers 20 down through 11 for both you and the fans, what comes to your mind?
Well, Dave, I'm going to tell you, when a guy like me sees this list, I have dreams of this being a funny car field today.
Can't argue. Some great picks. Can't wait to see what happens when number 10 gets revealed next week when we head out to Sonoma, California.